It is aligned to the intervertical space that we have seen.
Значит, вот те ветки, которые мы сейчас видим на экране, это зоны неба. Вот. Если мы говорим о внутренних, нет, вот сейчас чуть-чуть поправили, видите изображение? Это зона покрытая, соответственно. То, что в середине покрытое, то, что в краю не покрытое.
This is a proximal release then, you give me? Distal release. So, now we just come down and show me the body of his hands. Very nice. Stop there for me, please. Now, all this needs is just pulling this wire. So, I've not used the stem for this. You take your picture line. There's no need to push the stem or do anything. All that happens is the stem starts to undo itself. And you can see over here that the stem is beginning to release. And you can see the stem opening very nicely. Now remember, I've got the benefit of the endoscopic view, so if I need to push the stem down later, we can.
Также мы можем контролировать себя с помощью эндоскопической картины, и все нужно стать немножко позиционировать, это можно сделать.
So I'm just going to continue to release the stent. I'm coming probably.
Я продолжаю открывать стент.
So can you come up, please? Up. Okay, so my proximal stent is in a good position. I'm happy with that. So I'm probably halfway up the stent.
Это зона сужения, да?
And what you can see is the wasting of the stent here. Can everyone see how we're in the middle of the stricture here? The middle of the stent is in the middle of the stricture. Now, if you look at the endoscopic picture, I'm just coming up to the one last part. And very soon you're going to see the flange beginning to open. I'm just going to pull up just a couple of millimeters here. And very soon, you're going to see the proximal flange release. I didn't have enough spinach for breakfast today. I'm just going to pull off a little bit.
Okay.
Now, if my measurements are correct, I wanted the top of the stent to be at about 28 centimeters from the incisors. And we are 27, so it will shorten a little bit. But. But if you see the plural picture here, how tight the waist is, so I'm comfortable that if this patient has chemo radiotherapy and the stricture improves, this can fall in the stomach, I'm not so worried. Now I'm just very carefully going to
do it. I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. I'm going
to do it. I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. I'm going to earlier about stenting, you were mentioning about this particular stent and the registry that you
were... Thanks, I want to take this initial to talk about the new prospective registry which is organized by the Russian Society of Endoscopy.
Нет, про регистр, который делает сердечным обществом, изучает.
За работу, да?
За
постконтировку. Совместно с королем, да, вы работаете сейчас речи.
Yeah, this will allow to collect prospective data through a website program on all ultraflex stent placed for malignant dysphagia for the next 12 months. So we hope to have a huge database to be analyzed. Make sure that we have good outcome, good control of complication, that we can follow the patient very properly. And of course, we can prepare a nice manuscript to show what is the situation of esophageal stenting in this country. That would be great.
And we will store all the data on the treatment of the patient and the patient's stent complex, so that we can analyze the results of the treatment and what situation is in our country.
I think this is a fantastic initiative because you have seen that we did this in, I was counting, it took us, you know, 8 minutes to put the stent in. But the stent placement is done very, very differently in different places. In my country, in the UK, people still do this very, very awkwardly, and they make hard work of this. Whereas actually, if you go back to first principles, and you don't complicate things, it's one of the most simple interventions that we as endoscopists do, but it can be done very, very badly. And so I think I support it, and I think...
Thank you, and I want to thank you specifically because you very nicely show the tips and the tricks for proper position and placement of a cultaflex. You nicely show that the cultaflex must be placed just across, completely across the suture with the front, above and below, in order to keep the stent very stationary inside the suture. It's a very good point. If you look to the floor image now, do we have floor now? Okay, you can see how nicely the work the cultaflex is adapting his own morphology of the structure of the esophagus, and it will take about 24 or 48 hours to fully deploy inside the structure. So thanks for the
Thank you.